NCLT had asked for a monitoring committee to be appointed by members nominated by Piramal Capital and Housing Finance Limited, as well as from the side of the Committee of Creditors. And now we are exclusively picking up from sources the details of who is going to be appointed on this monitoring committee. We are picking up from sources that Piramal Capital and Housing Finance Limited's CEO Jairam Sridharam himself is going to be a part of this monitoring committee that will be overseeing the implementation of the resolution plan by Piramal. And also the second member appointed by PCHFL is Mr. Khushru Jijina, who is the MD of Piramal Capital and Housing Finance Limited. So very two important members nominated by the resolution applicant in this case. And remember, NCLT had given a breakup of who all should be appointed. It was supposed to be a 7-member committee. They themselves had appointed former SEBI ED, Mr. Ashok Kakkar, on the monitoring committee from their side. At the same time, they had said that the RBI-appointed administrator can too be a part of this monitoring committee. We understand Mr. R. Subramanian Kumar, who is the RBI-appointed administrator for DHFL, he will be a part of the monitoring committee as well. Now, the other 3 members were to come from the side of the Committee of Creditors. So for that, we are understanding from sources that the representatives will be from the top 2 lenders. One is SBI, which has the highest exposure, and the second nominee will be from Union Bank of India, the company which has, which is the lead banker in this case. And the third representative will be from the debenture trustee, who is managing, the NCD holders, which form a huge part of the COC of DHFL as well. So these are going to be a part of the 7-member managing committee that has come through. But very importantly, another development that happened now is that the COC of DHFL has rejected the idea of redistribution of funds or increasing payout to small creditors, to FD holders as well. Remember, in the order that NCLT had passed, they had asked the COC to consider increasing the payout to small creditors, including the Army Group, and also to fixed deposit holders who have become a dissenting class because they did not vote in favor of Piramal's plan. And now the COC has considered it, voted, and we understand from sources that 89% of the COC has voted against any further fund redistribution. So we understand that the next step is going to be that the COC will apprise the NCLT of these updates. They will inform them of the voting outcome as well. NCLT had, of course, totally left it on to the COC to take a decision on this, but they had requested them to reconsider. The entire point that NCLT had made is that the COC can take a call based on their own commercial wisdom. Now, after apprising the NCLT of this decision, the managing committee will then take over, because NCLT had given them two weeks time for the COC to consider on the fund redistribution matter. That also ends this week. And after that, the managing committee will take over to oversee the implementation of the resolution process, which has to be implemented in a matter of 90 days. But there will be some litigation that we must expect. Kapil Wadhwan's plea is pending in the Supreme Court to consider his offer as well. On the other hand, we understand that 63 Moons is going to be moving a higher court against NCLT's order accepting Piramal's resolution plan. So all those litigations may delay the final implementation, but it can start officially now with NCLT's approval coming in, until and unless there is any stay that might come in from any of the higher courts. At this point in time, the managing committee is in place for the implementation of DHFL's resolution plan.